The question gives the concentration of hydroxide ion as 3.7 times 10 to the negative 11 molar and wants us to find three things, which are pH, pOH, and concentration of H+. I've posted a video explaining the six formulas for pH calculations. We'll be using a few of them here. Since we have the concentration of OH-, we can use this formula and we'll be able to find the pOH. Alternatively, we can also start with this formula and we can find the concentration of H+. Now, it doesn't matter which formula we start with because we need to find both values anyway. So I'll just start with the first formula. The first formula is pOH is equals to negative log of OH-. We plug in the value of OH- and that gives us 10.43 for pOH. There's no unit required for pOH and pH, so we just leave the number as is. Now, using this calculated pOH, we can then easily find the value of pH. Using the relationship formula where pH plus pOH is 14, we plug in the value of pOH, do the subtraction, and we get pH is 3.57. Now that we have pH, we can use that to find the concentration of H+. We find the antilog of negative 3.57 and we get 2.7 times 10 to the negative 4 molar. It's important not to forget the unit molar for concentration. This is one way to find the concentration of H+ from pH. Another way is to find the concentration directly from OH concentration. And we use this relationship equation. So we plug in the given OH- concentration from the question and we should get 2.7 times 10 to the negative 4 molar. These two numbers are the same, the one that we found in the first method and the second method, because it's referring to the same concentration. To recap, here's the strategy that we use to calculate the values for pH, pOH, and H+ given OH- concentration. So we started with the OH- concentration and then we found the value of pOH, and from there pOH we look for pH, and then what we did was we used pH to find H+. Now that's one way of finding H+. Another way is that we go directly from OH- concentration and we find H+ concentration directly. There are multiple ways to get to where you need to go. It doesn't matter, there's no right or wrong here. I just want to show you how all these values are interrelated. I hope the video was helpful. Do subscribe and thanks for watching.